Hi, my name is Bintu and today I am going to teach you how to create a circular singly linked list. I assume that you have already seen my video of creating a singly linked list. If you haven't, I am providing you the link in the description box. Please view that video. That is going to help you a lot in understanding this video. The only difference between a singly linked list and the circular singly linked list is that the pointer of the last node will again point to the first node. So let us start understanding this program. I am writing this code in C language, but you can always convert it into C++. It is very easy, the logic remains the same. Here I am assuming the node comprising of two fields, two members. One is integer data member and another is a pointer, which will point to the structure of type node. That is, it is a self-referential structure. Besides this integer data, you can have many other types of data members also. Just to make the program simple, I am taking one integer variable here, right? And here, this is a pointer, start list, which will always point to the first node of my circular linked list. And these are the prototypes of the two functions that I am going to use in this program. One is create circular linked list. It is of type void. It won't return anything. And this is display circular linked list. Obviously, this will create the linked list and this will display the circular linked list, right? I am initializing the start list pointer to be null, right? So this is null. You're calling the circular linked list function. Let's jump to that function. This is that. See, here I am making use of two pointers. One is new node, another is temp. Okay. Variable k is a character variable which is initialized to small y. This is a while loop which will keep running for the time the value of variable k is either small y or capital Y. Okay. So, in this program, you will be creating nodes for the circular linked list for the time the user wants. That is, after adding every node, you will be prompting the user if the user wants to add more nodes or not. If the user presses Y, then the loop will be repeated to ask for the another node. If the user wants to stop, the user will press no to exit from this while loop, right? So here, because the value of k is already Y, it will go into this if block. You are checking whether the start list is null. Because the circular linked list is not yet created, the start list pointer is still null, so it will go here. Here you are creating a new node by name new node. This is what this statement is doing. Sizeof function will find out the number of bytes consumed by this node structure. Because it is using one integer variable and one pointer, an integer variable takes 2 bytes, assuming that a pointer takes 1 byte, so the sizeof function will return the 3 bytes for this node structure. Malloc will allocate the memory for this number of bytes. So 3 bytes will be allocated for this node structure and those 3 bytes will be typecasted into the node pointer. That is, this memory will be used by the structure of type node and that memory allocated will be assigned to this new node. So shortly, a new node is created. This is new node created. Recall that the node comprises of two members. One is data for keeping the data and the second is the pointer next, which will point to the next node. So new node is created. You are asking the user to enter integer value for that data member of the new node. Suppose the user enters 5. That will be assigned to the data member of new node. Start list pointer is set to point at new node. So start list pointer is set to point at new node. To make this node to appear as a circular linked list, you are making the next pointer of new node to point at start list. In these statements where pointer is used, left is asked to point at right. Right? The left is what? The next member of new node. The next member of new node is asked to point at start list or new node, whatever. Both are pointing at the same node. The next pointer of new node is set to point at start list. So it is pointing at itself. This statement makes it appear as a circular linked list. Can you see that? After that, one extra pointer, temp is set to point at start list. See, this is temp is set to point at start list. So let me tell you what is the use of these three pointers. Temp will be used for connecting the nodes in between. Start list will be set to point at the first node always. And new node will be used for creating new nodes. Let's see it how. Because if block was executed, control will never go into else. User is asked whether the user wants to add more. Let us assume that user presses Y. This Y will be assigned to K. This is while loop. If the value of k is lowercase y or uppercase y, it will go into this while loop. Because the user has entered y, control will go over here. If start list is null, no, the start list is pointing to some node. So it won't go in this if block, it will come over here. The new node is created. See, new node is created here. So that means new node pointer will not be pointing at the first node now. It is pointing at the new node which is just created. You are asking the user to enter the value for the data member of the new node. Suppose user enters 2, that will be assigned to the data member of the new node. You can see that temp is used for connecting the nodes. The next pointer of temp is set to point at new node. So next pointer of temp will be set to point at new node. It won't be pointing at start list now. It will point at this new node. After that, this next pointer of new node is set to point at start list. See, the next pointer of temp is set to point at new node. After that, the next pointer of new node is set to point at start list. Can you see that? This code is repeated here. See, this is the only difference in the singly linked list and the circular singly linked list. That is, the pointer of the last node is set to point at the first node again. After that, again, temp is set to point at new node. Temp won't be pointing at the first node now, it will point at the second node. Why? Because it is through this temp node that you will be pointing the new nodes. See how again. After this else block, control will come over here. Want to add more? Suppose the user presses Y. Control will go again here. Is start list null? No. Control will come over here. Create a new node by a new node. So new node will be created here. So new node won't be pointing at the second node now. It is pointing at the third newly created node. You are asking the user to enter the value for the data member of new node. Suppose the user presses 8, 8 will be assigned to the data member of the new node. The next pointer of temp is set to point at new node. So the next pointer of temp won't be pointing at the start node now. It will point at the new node. Can you see that? So this verifies that temp is always used to connect the nodes. That is that. After that, then the next pointer of new node is set to point at start list. The next pointer of new node is set to point at start list. This is how the circular linked list is created. After executing of creating of circular linked list, control will go into the main function where you are calling the display circular linked list. Display circular linked list will simply display the linked list. Let us see. You are making use of a temp pointer here. Temp is set to point at the start list. We are assuming that this is the circular linked list created by us. Temp will point at start list. If temp is not equal to null, it will go in if block. And if temp is null, that means the circular linked list is not yet created. In that case, it will display a message, circular linked list is empty. But because temp is not null, it is pointing at start list, it will go here. The content in the circular linked list are, this is a text message which will be displayed on the screen. It will display the data member of temp. So you will get 5 on the screen. After that, temp is asked to point where the next member of temp is pointing. So the next pointer of temp is pointing at 2. So temp will come and point at 2. After that, the while loop will execute. Here you are checking until and unless the temp pointer reaches the node where start list is pointing, keep repeating this while loop. Temp is pointing at 2, start list is at 5, right? So because temp is not equal to start list, it will go into this while loop. Display the data member of temp. So you will get 2 on the screen. Temp is asked to point where its next pointer is pointing. So temp will go and point where its next pointer is pointing. It will point at 8. It will go here. It will go into the while loop. Is temp not equal to start list? No. Start list is pointing at 5 and temp is at 8. It will go into while loop. Display the data member of temp. So you get 8 on the screen. After that, the temp is set to point where its next member is pointing. Next member of temp is pointing at start list. So temp will go and point at start list. If the temp and start list are not pointing at the same node, then only you go in while loop. But temp and start list are pointing at the same node, it will exit. So you will get this output, 5, 2 and 8 on the screen. Let's run this program. I am using Kigwin software to execute C programs. Kigwin provides the Unix environment in Windows. See, this is the program that I have already written, that we have already discussed. Let's compile this. See, compiled, no error. Let's run this. Enter an integer value. Let us enter, say, 10. Want to add more? Yes. Enter an integer value. Let us enter 20. Want to add more? Yes. Let us enter 30. Want to add more? No. See, the content in the circle linked list are 10, 20 and 30. So, this program is working perfectly well. If you get stuck, you can mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. Even for the code, you can mail me. Please subscribe to my channel. This is the channel name. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.